Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. So in the previous video we saw how to create users in MongoDB. Now from this video and on we are going to see how to manipulate data in MongoDB database. We will see bunch of stuffs like creating collections, inserting data, finding the data and all that stuff in a form of a series of videos. So let's start with the first one. So first we are going to create a collection. So basically you have to understand what does a collection mean. A collection is basically similar to what we have as tables in MySQL database. So in a database you can have multiple tables in a MySQL database. Similarly here in MongoDB you can create multiple collections within a same database. So as we saw in the previous video, we have created a database called customers and we had created a user for it. So now we are currently active on the same database customers. So let's get into the syntax of creating a collection. So the syntax is db.createCollection, and within the parentheses we are going to pass a string which is going to be the name of the collection. So let's give any name. Let's say our collection name will be customer. So we'll give customer and hit enter. So it says okay. So it means we have created the collection. Now if you want to check the number of collections you have on a particular database, you have to just type show collections and you will see the collections that are currently present on your database. So now after we have created a collection, now we'll see how to insert a data into the database. So now I'm using a text editor just to write the query here so you can actually read it carefully, and we are just going to copy and paste this on the console. So the syntax to insert a data is db.customer, which is our collection name, dot insert, and within this it is going to take an object which is basically a document. So here we will add the fields of the document. So let's say the first field is first name and we'll just give any name, let's say Bruce, and a last name field which will be Wayne, so it's basically Batman. So I'll copy this and paste it here. And after you hit enter, you will see that it says an inserted is 1. So it means that we have inserted a data. So now to check the contents of a collection, we have to do db.customer.find. So now you can see our data has been entered and it generates a unique ID automatically. So you don't have to create a ID and put it to auto increment and set it as primary key. You don't have to do all that stuff which you usually do in a MySQL database, because MongoDB does it for you automatically. It generates a unique object ID. So now this was a case if you want to add a single data, but what if you want to add multiple data at the same time? So in that case what you have to do is, instead of just passing an object, you have to create an array and there you have to pass an object. So we'll create an array and within this we are going to create an object, and again we are going to just paste this first name and last name fields and we'll change the content. So let's say we want to keep the second data as Oliver Queen. Okay, I'm just taking the name of the characters from DC Comics. So next, after that, for adding the another field, we are just going to place a comma and then again second set of curly braces, and within this we'll place the second fields. So here we'll just change the name to, let's say we will add Clark Kent, which is Superman. So now copy this and paste it to your console. So now we have inserted the multiple data. So in case you want to add multiple data at the same time, you just need to keep them in an array just like this. So if you remember the slides from the first video, there I mentioned that in MongoDB there is no static schema, it's dynamic schema. So I'll just show you what that exactly means now. Let's say we are making another entry. So we'll give a first name and last name, but now we want to add a gender as well. So for the first three fields we didn't add gender, but in MongoDB you can add any field at any point and you can remove any field at any point for any data. So that's the best part of MongoDB. You don't have to predefine a schema that you must have these values. So at any point you can just change those values. So that's the beauty of MongoDB. I mean, it's awesome, really awesome. So we'll add a gender here for Peter Parker And obviously we know it's Spider-Man, so he's male. And we'll insert this and let's see what happens. And yeah, there you can see now. So for the first three fields, we have first name and last name. But for Peter Parker, we have added the gender as well. So I hope now that point is clear to you about the dynamic schema. So now let's see what are different types of fields you can add. So you just saw till now that we have added a string, but we can add an object as well. So let's say we are adding an address. So we are giving street number, something XYZ, pin number. So we are again adding an object. So we are having a key value pair for each of them. And also apart from objects, we can create arrays as a fields. So let's say we have an array of roles. So for Peter Parker, I mean, what role we can add? Let's say a superhero. Yeah, definitely. And student. Yeah, he was a student. So we can add array. We can add objects. We can add string, numbers. We can put field for images, videos, anything we have. But we are not going to talk about images and videos in this video. That is out of the scope of this video. So let's stick to this. So I think that's good for today. Yeah. So in the next video, we'll learn how to do more manipulations of the data in MongoDB database. So I'll see you in the next video. Also, if you're enjoying the series, consider subscribing and watch the previous video. If you haven't started with the series of MongoDB, it's for complete beginners. So you will definitely enjoy it, and leave your feedback in the comment section down. So that's it. Bye-bye.